Dear students, good morning. Today we will be seeing about viral mycoplasmal pneumonia. Yesterday we had seen about bacterial pneumonia and lobular pneumonia or bronchoalveolar pneumonia we have seen. Today we will be seeing viral and the bacterial pneumonia we had seen finished yesterday. Today we will be seeing the second type, that is a viral or mycoplasmal pneumonia, or it is also called primary atypical pneumonia. So in this pneumonia, it is definitely patchy inflammatory changes. It is characterized by this viral pneumonia is characterized by patchy inflammatory changes confined to the interstitial tissue of the lung. It is confined patchy inflammatory changes in X-ray, you will see naked eyes, you cannot see. When you take the X-ray, in that you can see patchy inflammatory changes. We can see which is confined to the interstitial tissue of the lung without any exudate. That means there will not be any secretions without any exudate. Exudate is secretion with the serous fluid which comes from the interstitial part. So there won't be any interstitial fluid. Will not be any exudate. Will not be present in viral pneumonia, and it can viral pneumonia, and it can attack in any age. It can attack in any age. That is, it can attack the child also. It can attack the adult also, and it can attack the old people also. The seriousness of the disease varies from mild to transient and from severe to fulminant. From mild to transient and severe to fulminant. Now this was about the in brief about the viral pneumonia. Now we see about the etiology. What is the etiology of viral pneumonia? This etiology is caused by an organism, Mycoplasma pneumonia. It's called by the virus which causes this infection. It is mycoplasmal pneumonia, and many viruses like parainfluenza, H influenza virus, adenovirus, rhinovirus, cytomegalovirus, chlamydia virus, and Q fever. These are the many viruses which all can affect the lungs and it can cause pneumonia. The main organism is Mycoplasma pneumonia, and along with that, other viruses which causes this viral pneumonia is influenza, H influenza, parainfluenza virus, adenovirus, cytomegalovirus, chlamydia, and rhinovirus and Q fever. These are all the viruses which can cause viral pneumonia. This viral pneumonia, it remains confined to the upper respiratory tract. Upper respiratory tract means it will start from the nasopharynx till the trachea. It will be the pharynx, larynx, and then up to the trachea only it will be lasting. But in certain cases, it may extend to interstitium of the lungs. It is restricted to upper respiratory tract, and it can extend down. And that conditions in which cases it can extend down is malnutrition, when the diet is not proper. Diet is not proper means the high protein diet means it will heal. It can heal. It will do all the repairing works. If the diet is low in proteins, then it is protein, vitamins, and trace elements which helps in fighting the immunity. The diet is not having vitamin C. So in all those things, what happens is the infection can spread, extend down to the lung. In these cases, and along with malnutrition, it is also chronic debilitating diseases, like if the patient is bedridden, if they are having any terminal illness, or the patient is alcoholic, because alcoholism means they will be having plenty of salivation. So because of the plenty of salivation they are having, if they will have that infection will catch, it is very easy, because of the excessive salivation it will go down. So these are the conditions in which this infection will spread down. Then now we will see about how our lungs will appear in case of gross examination, if we do the gross examination, how the lung will be appearing. The lung will be appearing patchy to massive, and widespread consolidation will be there. There will be consolidation, means solidification. The secretions which are there, they have solids. So that will not be, the whole lung will not be affected, but that will be present, it will be in patches. To from patchy to massive and widespread. Widespread, so maybe spread all over the lung, in widespread consolidation of one or both the lungs. If it is one lung is affected, it will be in one lung. If both the lungs affected, in both the lungs it will be there. And because of the consolidation, the lung will be very heavy. The lung will be very heavy and congested, and it will secrete frothy or bloody liquid. There will be, it will be very heavy, then it will be giving it secretes frothy and bloody fluid, it will be secreting. So this is about when if you let gross examination, the general examination, which will be seen. Now we'll be seeing about histopathology. In histopathology, histologically, what we will see, that there are four types of incidence: interstitial inflammation. Interstitial inflammation means the thickening of the alveolar sacs will get thickened due to congestion, that is due to the edema, and the inflammation is there. The interstitial inflammation will be there due to the collection of secretions, due to the edema, because of the edema and inflammation, already there is congestion. So there will be interstitial inflammation will be there. Second is necrotizing bronchiectasis. So what is necrotizing bronchiectasis? That means focal inflammations will be there. Means that area necrosis, when there is the oxygen supply is depleted, when that oxygen supply is depleted, it is cut off, that area will become necrosed because it is through the blood supply they are getting the oxygen. So that if that is cut off, then suppose the consolidation is happened, consolidation happens when there is no blood supply. So what happens is it will be necrosis will be there. So necrosis, bronchiectasis. Then third is reactive changes, the lining of the epithelial cells of the bronchioles and the alveoli proliferates in the presence of virus. The lining of the epithelial lining of epithelial cells of the bronchioles and the alveoli, in their proliferation will be there, and hence the presence of virus will be there. So that will be causing the reactive changes. Then third is alveolar changes. Alveolar changes, edema will happen. Why? Because the lungs are already edematous. Fluid collection is there, fibrin is there, then scanty inflammatory exudate is there, and this weighting of alveolar walls. The alveolar walls will be painting pink in color due to the hyaline membrane. The hyaline membrane present will be pink in color. So these are the four changes which will be happening. Now, histologically, when we say that is in interstitial inflammation will be there because there is already inflammation is there, edema is there, because of the congestion is there, and because of that interstitial inflammation is there. Now necrotizing bronchitis, because of the consolidation, there will be the area will be left due to the lack of oxygen, it will be getting necrosis, necrotizing bronchitis is there. And reaction changes due to excessive presence of the virus, and why? Because of the lining of the epithelial cells of the lung gets proliferated, and hence presence of virus will be there. Then in alveolar changes, as it is already edematous, fluids are present, there is scanty inflammatory exudate will be present, which in turn will be alveolar walls will be coating, and if you see the hyaline membrane, it will be pink hyaline membrane will be present. So that is about the four histological changes will be there. Now we'll see about the clinical features. What will be there? Clinical features: the patient will be having fever, headache, muscle ache will be having, dry, non-productive cough will be there. Will be coughing, but there won't be any production will be there. Mucus will be there. So dry, non-productive cough will be there. Then retrosternal burning will be there. There will be retrosternal burning will be there. And if you take the X-ray, that will be showing consolidation. So this was about. Viral inflammation, viral and mycoplasma pneumonia. So we have seen in mycoplasma pneumonia, what will be happening? The lungs will be having patchy inflammatory changes, which is confined to the interstitial tissue of the lung. Without an exudate, there will not be an exudate. Then its severity varies from mild to transient and severe to fulminant. Then we have seen that this can affect any age. Any age, this infection will be affecting in any age. Then when we'll be doing, it will be affecting in any age. In the other viruses, the virus which is the etiology, the virus which will be causing this infection is mycosomal. The infection is mycoplasma pneumonia, and other viruses it will be causing is H influenza virus, then cytomegalovirus, chlamydiasis, then rhinovirus, and Q fever. These are the different causative organisms which will be causing. Then we have seen about the gross examination. In gross examination, we will be seeing patchy to massive widespread of virus, and there will be consolidation of both the lungs. Lungs will be heavy and congested. Lungs will be heavy and congested. Then we saw about the histological changes. In that, there are four types in the restriction inflammation will be there. Necrotizing bronchitis will be there. Reactive changes will be there. And then aeruginous changes will be there. Then we are seeing the clinical features in which the patient will be having fever, headache, muscle ache, dry non-productive cough will be there. Then respiratory burning will be there. And we see the X-ray. In X-ray, they will be showing probably consolidation. So in this case, the blood samples has to be sent to see about the if any infections are there. Blood culture has to be done. X-ray has to be done to see what is from the infection is there. So this was all about the viral pneumonia. Hope you have understood, and go and study, and thank you.